Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Jake from todaysiphone.com, and here's your TIP Daily for November 12th, 2012. Okay, so let's start off with some iOS 6 news. Now, Apple pushed the second beta of iOS 6.1 to developers today, and there aren't any major changes, but there are a couple minor things to report. First of all, there's a new button in the advertising section of the settings application labeled Reset Advertising Identifier. According to the description that Apple provided, this button resets the advertising identifier so that the future requests will return a different value. A couple other bug fixes include a repair of the panorama feature, which was messed up in iOS 6.1 beta 1, but it seems to be working again now in beta 2. And Apple has also added a welcome screen with a description of Passbook to the Passbook application to kind of help newbies ease into using the app. If you're a registered developer and are running beta 2 of iOS 6.1 and you've noticed any other significant changes to report, I'd love to hear them in the comment section down below. Moving on, if you're still trying to get your hands on an iPhone 5, you'll be happy to know that shipping times have decreased on Apple's online store from 3 to 4 weeks to 2 to 3. Now again, this is just one option for picking up the iPhone 5. You can also do personal pickup, which is basically ordering the device online anytime between 10 p.m. and 4 a.m. And you can actually search the stock of local retail stores around you. And if one of those stores has the model that you want in stock, you can just buy that model and they'll save it for you and you can go pick it up the next day. And of course, there's always just waiting in line or going to an Apple store or a Best Buy or something and just hoping that they have the one you want. And finally, Apple has started something called the Blue Sky Project, which is a lot like Google's 20% time initiative, which allows employees to take a certain amount of time, in Apple's case 2 weeks, to work on any side project that they want. Now this is really cool because in other companies that have offered this previously, a lot of these unique side projects have actually been developed into full-on consumer devices. So Apple moving forward with a program like this is definitely a step in the right direction as far as innovation is concerned, and I'm very excited to see what can possibly come out of this. Okay, well that's all the big news for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Your question of the day today is, if you worked at Apple and you had this 2 week period to do whatever you wanted with whatever Apple's resources you could use, what would you do? You can let me know in the comment section down below or on Twitter at TIP_Jake. Please don't forget the links to everything I talked about in this video in the description down below, so definitely check those out. And as always, for more news, views, and reviews, don't forget to head over to todaysiphone.com.